Aloha, welcome back to Jerf Life. This is video number 2 in the tutorial, how to make a perfect French press. So if you haven't watched video number 1, go check that out. It's all the equipment that you're going to need for this process, and we're gonna get right to it here, making a perfect French press. So I'm just gonna throw these beans in, get these at a coarse consistency, and then I'll throw the water in, and we're looking for a water temperature of, I prefer right around 195 to 200. We've got 6 tablespoons of beans, a 2-to-1 cup ratio, 2 tablespoons to 1 cup of water. So we've got 3 cups of water, 6 tablespoons of beans to make our French press. Okay, so we've got our 6 tablespoons of coarse grounds. We're just gonna dump them right into the bottom of the French press. Notice I took out the plunger top, and in go our coarse beans. Our water is about 202 degrees. That's perfect, that's right where I want it. I've got my coarse grounds in here. I took the topper out. And now, very similar to the pour over, I'm going to start with a bloom with just a very small amount of water. Getting all the grounds. You can spin the cup a little bit to make it a little easier. Now we watch the bloom for about 30 to 45 seconds and you should see the coffee starts to expand and rise up in the bottom of your French press. Oh, that smell is killer, guys. Unlike a pour over, you don't need to get fancy with the pouring of the water, just because it's going to be sitting in there already and you're just filling it all the way to the top. So I like to spin it around, make sure you're still getting all the grounds floating on top wet. But once you're out of water, the next step is we take the plunger top and we just submerge the filter right on that top of the grounds there. We just want this filter plunger bottom part to be submerged slightly. So we just check it out here, we look in, we push down. Right there, you'll see the coffee just came up to the top there. I like to typically let this sit for another 30 seconds, maybe 45, and then we slowly start to plunge down. And you can see all of this here is the coffee, and then here at the bottom are all the grounds, and I just push down to the bottom. I hit the bottom there, and that is it. So now I know that my French press is ready to go once I get to the bottom. There's a little vent here that you can see. So you want to turn that to open, and you're ready to pour. I like to have a little thumb on the topper just to be safe. And look at that, guys. That is silky. That is a nice French press right there. That's amazing. Very, very silky, bold, lots of aroma, good flavor. And the cleaning is very, very easy. We just remove the plunger and then wash this off, spray it out, just make sure that there's no grounds still trapped in the filter, and then soap and water to rinse out the actual glass container for the French press, and that's it. Very, very easy maintenance, and it's a delicious cup of coffee. This is the Peruvian medium roast right here, and if you guys want to try a free sample on us, just follow the link and it will take you to our page where you can order a different quantity of samples. All you got to do is cover shipping. It's on the house, we'll send it out to you for you to try. And that is it for how to make a perfect French press. Thank you guys for checking out this tutorial video. I hope you gained some skills that help you to make a perfect cup of coffee. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comments. And if you know any friends that need to level up their coffee game, tag them or send this video to them. And click the link to get a free sample of Jerf Life coffee on us. All you gotta do is cover shipping. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Take care.